You know what that means. Holidays right around the corner. Are you ready to go? Well, Harman's is helping us out. Partly because they have a lot of stuff ready to go, which is a great way to do it. And then if not, if you want to get fancy and do the cooking, well, Chef Casey is here, and he has made the most delicious Brussels sprout recipe. I love Brussels sprouts. So your mama, she's missing out.
Well, I'm glad you enjoy them.
I know. We're going to convince your mom and all the others that don't like Brussels sprouts to love them. So
she's going to be texting me any minute now, I'm sure.
All right. She's like, stop talking about me on TV. Well, Casey, let's talk about it. So we're making this like a spicy caramel sauce to go on top of it, and you've been working on the sauce.
Right. So what we did, we added all the like the chili, the garlic, and why can't I think? Everything in there. And then we got the fish sauce, a little bit of water, some sugar in there. And then I just brought it up to a simmer, and I'm slowly just cooking this down. I'm actually almost there now, just into a nice caramel glaze. That's the sugar cooking in there. And then from there, I already have some made, and I fried the Brussels.
And so once it's done, do you need to let it sit or anything, or will it just kind of...
You don't need to let it sit. You just want to strain it out, all that stuff. I mean, you can leave it in there if you wanted to, but I like to strain it out. It just looks a little bit better.
Yeah.
You don't have as many chunks of stuff in there.
Yes, smart.
So then we toss that in with our Brussels.
And you've just cut them up pretty small, too. They're easier to eat that way.
Yeah, just nice and quartered. They fan out a little bit when they're fried, and it is deep fried. Like, this isn't a healthy recipe.
Is anything on Thanksgiving? No.
Right, no. But, well, also, if you're just starting to eat vegetables, like, there's one goal down already.
Yes, you just fry them a little bit, and then you can eat the vegetables. It's the way to do it.
And then, yeah, you serve that on a platter or however you want to serve it. I put a little lemon slice on the side because of the little bit of acid.
I've got that.
And then you can even add, like, just to make it more unhealthy, a little bit of pancetta or prosciutto.
Or make it better, right?
A little bacon. Yeah, make it better.
Something so good. I've been chowing down on this. It is so delicious, you guys. And I think something that a lot of people, you know, if they are kind of anti-Brussels sprouts, they might actually like this. It's something great. I think Brussels sprouts have kind of made a comeback in the recent years at Thanksgiving dinners. I see them a lot.
I think you're right. Brussels sprouts definitely have gotten a lot better. We've learned how to cook them a little bit better than just steaming them.
Yes. I think that's so true. So also, you guys have so many different things at Harman's. If people want to just come in and grab the rolls or pies, whatever, you have it.
Right. We've got a variety of rolls, bocce rolls, dinner rolls, whatever kind of rolls you want for your holiday. We've got a bunch of stuff pre-prepped. Like I said, we got the Brussels. We also even have just pre-cut up potatoes and everything.
Makes your life so easy in the kitchen.
Pies, yeah, cheese balls, whatever you need for your holiday, we're ready.
I have been texting with the two different families saying, okay, what's everybody bringing? And I said, what do you people want that I can buy? Because I'm not going to be cooking. So I'll be heading over to Harman's in just a little bit to next week to get all of my good stuff.
Perfect.
Lots of locations. Casey, thank you so much for being in here. So good. You guys definitely make this. It's delicious.
I'm glad you like it. Thank you.
We'll be right back.